Welcome to this course on Introduction to Financial Markets. If you want to learn about financial markets and get a brief understanding of how they work, then you're right where you should be. First, let's understand why you need to know about financial markets. Suppose a well-known company in your country makes an announcement about some exciting new projects they plan to complete. As a result, there is a buzz about the company all over the media, and the stock price of the company goes up. This news thrills you too. And you want to make a profit from trading in the stock. To be able to spot and grab such opportunities, you should know how financial markets operate. Let's consider another reason why a knowledge of financial markets is necessary. It is generally said that financial markets rise over a long period. To place things in perspective, consider the chart shown on the screen. The chart shows the performance of the US financial markets. While there are lots of ups and downs along the way, the market has generally risen in the long run. This is, more or less, the same story in nearly all geographies. Here's the market performance for the same duration from another country. This chart shows the performance of the Indian financial market. These charts indicate that investing in financial markets can be beneficial in the long run. Again, you need to have a working knowledge of financial markets in order to take advantage of such market behavior. Any individual new to the financial markets have some common questions such as, what are stocks? Which stocks should I buy? What are the exchanges? And what do they do? Who are brokers? And so on. In this course, you will learn the fundamental concepts which will eventually answer all these questions. To start with, you will be introduced to the financial markets. Next, you will learn about instruments traded therein. Then, you will be exposed to primary and secondary markets. After that, you will learn about the trading workflow. As you go through this course, you will learn about various entities that make up the financial markets. You will also learn about various financial intermediaries that operate in financial markets. Brokers, who help us connect to financial markets, will also be discussed. Next, you will learn about central security depositories where your securities are stored. Then, the roles performed by exchanges will be discussed. After that, the clearinghouse's roles will be explained. And finally, the regulators in financial markets will be taught. This will enable you to explain how various financial intermediaries work together. You will also learn about the different roles investors and traders perform. These roles will help you understand what are different types of market participants operating in financial markets. Towards the end of the course, you will be exposed to concepts like speculation and arbitrage. Lastly, you will learn various types of financial markets, and we will end the course by explaining commonly used jargon in financial markets. We have taught all the topics in a detailed and simple to understand manner through interactive videos. There are objective questions to test you along the way. We hope you enjoy the interactive learning throughout this course. Good luck!